Hi, this is the lecture about powers or exponents as they are also called. Powers or exponents are used to represent lengthy calculations like when you are multiplying one number by itself again and again in a very simplified form. For example, if you want to say that I have to multiply 2 3 times, so all you have to do is you say 2 multiplied by 2 3 times. If you want to say multiply 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 5 times, then you can say 1 by 2 multiplied by itself 5 times. This is powers or exponents. Now we're going to talk about the basic ones here, which we will see a lot in calculations. These are square, cube, square root, and cube root. A square of a number is something like this. The second power of the number is called the square of the number, and all you have to do is just multiply the number by itself. Okay? Similarly, the cube of a number is the third power of the number, and we just multiply the number by itself 3 times. That is the cube. What is the square root? The square root of a number, let's say the number p. Okay, we have to find the square root of number p. This is going to be equal to, let's say, suppose p is equal to q into q. Then, this is how we represent square root. So when we say square root of p, this will be equal to q. So the square root of a number is a number which when multiplied with itself will give you the starting number. Again, the square root of a number, this is our number here. The square root of number p is the number q, which when multiplied by another q will give you p. For example, the square root of number 25 is 5, because when we multiply 5 by 5, we get 25. Right? Similarly, the cube root of a number is a number, let's say the cube root of number q is a number which when raised to its third power will give us the number q itself. For example, the number 27. The cube root for 27 is 3, because, and this is how we represent cube root. So when we say square root of 25, this is 5. When we say cube root of 27, this is equal to 3, because 3 raised to its third power, 3 into 3 into 3, will give you 27. So this is square, cube, square root, cube root. Now how do you calculate the square root or the cube root or the square or the cube or any other, you know, exponent as such? Suppose you have to find out the square root of a number. Now what you're going to do in this case is, the first way that we do it is by prime factorization. What we do in prime factorization is, simply, we factorize the given number in its prime factors. For example, if we take number 21 and we say we have to prime factorize it, then we say factor 3 into factor 7, this will give you 21. Both of these are prime numbers, right? So you reduce the number in its prime factors and you get the prime factorization, and from that you will have to choose groups of two similar prime factors each. For example, if you have something like this, 3 into 3 into 7 into 7, then you take this group and you take this group. From here you'll take 1, 3. From here you'll take 1, 7. Then you will multiply this, and whatever you will get will be the square root of this number. Okay, suppose this was your 441, then you get 21. I'll give you a simple example. Let's say 100 is the number for which we have to find out the square root. So let's prime factorize it. Let's divide it by 2 first. So you get 50. Then again divide it by 2, so you get 25. Then divide by 5, so you get 5. Then divide by 5, so you get 1. So you have 2 into 2 into 5 into 5 is the prime factorization for 100. Now group these and these. So what you get here is, take 1 hit, you know, 2 from here and a 5 from here. Now you multiply them, and when you do that, what you get is the square root for 100. You prime factorize the number, you take groups of 2, you take 1 from each, you multiply them, and you get the square root. If you want to find out whether a given number is a perfect square or not, whether it can have a square root which is a natural number or not, let's say you have to find out whether 300 is a perfect square or not. So you just prime factorize it. Again, 2 into 2 into 3 into 5 into 5. Now you can see clearly that you have one group here, you have another group here, but there's a problem here. Since you have a remaining prime factor, this will not, 300 will not be a perfect square. Now moving on to cube root, the formula is the same. This is how you will be doing it. Let's take 216. Now when I say 216, 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. You know, this is the prime factorization for 216. Now, instead of taking groups of 2, as in the case of square root, you take groups of 3 prime factors, which are similar, like 2 into 2 into 2 and 3 into 3 into 3. So with that, take 1 out from here, take 1 out from here, and with these factors, you multiply them to get the cube root for the given number. This is how you do cube, this is how you find out cube root or square root through prime factorization. Fine. There is one more method which we need to talk about. This method is called long division method. You won't be using this in competitive examinations, but some people like using this formula, so I'll tell you about it. What you do in this case is, suppose this is your given number and you have to find out the square root for this number. So what you'll do in this case is, beginning from your left, you'll make groups of 2. And it has a 0, so you keep a 0 here. That becomes your group of 2. Now you do something like this. And now, please follow closely. This is your first group. Now I have to get a number here which, when multiplied with itself, should be less than this group here or equal to it. Less than or equal to 9. This is what I have to get by putting a number over here. If I say put 1, then 1 into 1 is 1. It's less than 9. But I can still reach closer. Let's say I put in a 2. So 2 into 2 is 4. Still closer. Let's see. Why don't we put a 3? We get 3 into 3 equal to 9. So, now, this remainder here is less than number in question over here. So, we have to pull down the next group. Now, what you do over here is, you add the unit digit number to itself and you write it down over here and you push it to the tens digit. Okay, you add this number to itself, the unit digit number to itself, you push it to the tens digit, And now you have a unit digit remaining over here. You need not write it. Write this. Can be done like this. Now you have to put in a number in the units digit again so that it is either equal to 73 or the closest in number to 73. For example, if I put 62, suppose we put 0, okay, so you have 60. Then 60 into 0, okay, you have to multiply the unit digit with the given number like we did here. So you have to multiply 0 with 60, you'll get 0, which is less than 73, but we can definitely get closer. Why don't we write 61? 61 into 1 is 61, which is very close to 73. 62 into 2 will be 124, which will be larger than 73, which we do not want. So let's say we have a 1 here. That's that. Now again, we add a 1 here, that becomes 62, and we push this forward. So you have a unit digit remaining here. Now I'm going to pull down the 44 because this is less than this number here. Now I have a 1244 in this side. Now what do I multiply, what do I put in the unit digit so that it becomes, when multiplied with the number, it gets closest to this. So if I say 620 into 0, that will be 0, not my number. I can get closer. I can get something like this, but this is the number that we want. So we multiply, we put a 2 here, we multiply it by 2, we get a 0. So we get a 1 here and a 2 here, making it 312. This becomes your square root for 97344. This is the long division method. We have talked about a lot of different things in powers or exponents. Move on to the practice sheet. Best of luck.